Now it's time to get into something called imposters. And for this imposter section, you're going to have to put your spy hat on because you are going to become an inspector. And you're going to be inspecting sentences to find the things that look like verbs, but they are just pretending. They're not actually containing any action in the given sentence. So, I know that sounds weird, but let's check it out. In a simple sentence like this, you have something like, Fred likes singing. Well, the word singing is actually a verb word, right? I could say, you know, Chelsea was singing in the rain. And then that's actually happening. Chelsea was actively singing in the rain. So singing is our verb. But here, Fred is not doing any singing. It's not an action that he's doing. And so singing actually, in this case, ends up being a noun. And it is the direct object of likes. It's the thing that Fred likes. Fred likes singing. Now you can see how, even at this very small level, those are two very different sentences. The one sentence, or the, you know, if you think that singing is the verb, then you think to yourself, oh, okay, so Fred is singing right now. But if you recognize that there is no singing happening, that this is just describing Fred or telling you something about what Fred likes, you know, just giving you more character development, well, that's a whole different read. And when you get like 50 sentences like this and also much bigger sentences, it becomes a bigger deal. For example, and you don't have to get this sentence yet, but I'm going to throw a curveball at you. This is a sentence like what you might see on the SAT, right? It's big, it's long, and it's got a lot of stuff in there that look like verbs. Determination, yeah, okay, we like determine things, right? Manufacture, we definitely manufacture stuff, that's an action. Understanding, that's a thing. I can understand something, that's an action. I got you, okay. Trade, I can trade with people, I can use something, I can add to something. Those all look like verbs. Now, the skill that we're about to develop here is you have to be able to see which of those quote-unquote verbs are not actually verbs at all. Which ones are serving as actually nouns? Which ones are actually adjectives? And that, once you narrow it down, you can easily tell what the main verb of your sentence is because there's only one verb left. Now, sometimes there will be extra clauses and things, but you can see that as well. Now, just to show you exactly how prevalent prepositional phrases are in all of the, you know, complex reading that you guys are going to get into after grammar, I just want to show you this. It is literally, like I said, one prepositional phrase after another, and another, and another, and another, and another. This is what you're going to get into when you start reading. When I say that prepositional phrases are super important, I really, really mean it. And learning to think inside these packets of information is going to be huge. Being able to put those brackets into a sentence in your mind, huge. All right, cool. Let's get to it.